So there was this blog post here about fat package recipes, and there's some inspiring stuff in there. So, but I was already thinking about what a good workflow would be to basically maintain my own packages, and this is just a basically I'm just exploring what I could actually do. To achieve something, so let's just make their temp CD temp and do this first step here, where it's basically cloning, I guess, the SLinux policy repository. Takes a while. And in the meantime, let's have a look. So basically here it says CD to your Fedora branch, and then run the prep command. Fat package prep. And this takes a little while because the server is slow. That's unfortunate. This is probably not something you can do regularly, because then you'll probably get banned from the server, I guess. So CD as a Linux policy, and then Fedora 20. So that's F20, and here you have this. So now I should be able to let's just first git status. Nothing to commit, so that's clean. Git show, and this was January 8th, so that's pretty recent. So let's run a prep. Because, well, we want to actually modify something and then use that, or create a patch and use that, add that to the package. So now there should be, that's pretty much sucks, because, well, there's actually two. But we'll need to go to the main one, I guess. This is still, of course, in the damn, my mailbox closed. Nothing new there. So that sucks. Not sure if I'm able to create a repository inside this one. Git init. Seems that that's a possible. Git. Yeah. git commit. I'm just playing. Base. Oh, I'll just add test. This is just playing. So git show. This, yeah, I just added stuff. So yeah, at this point I probably need to branch. It's probably a good idea to branch B test, I guess. Oops. Git checkout. Fits new branch. Okay. So now let's see if we can find the post that actually where I actually opted or suggested some fix that. Where is it? Lists. And that's previous month. This is not it. Probably, yeah, so it's a small change here, I would say, in the domain. So we need to go to init if, nano, policy, modules, system, init. If and then the init, which was it, the init daemon domain. And then there's a couple of stuff, so above init rc. Oops. Deck. Init daemon domain. So this was the minus here, and this is the plus. Oops. And this is the plus. Weird. So here it's requiring init. God knows why it's requiring init. Nice. This is such a mess. This is you can't actually apply this, so let's just, this is not applicable. Let's just do the role transition on the init script file. So this one, init run daemon, that's what it's all about. Init run daemon. This is what it's all about. Oops. This is not very interesting either. This is it. So it's just a single rule. Git commit a change this for testing. And then there's this git patch, yeah, here. So I'm not sure if this is going to actually work, but let's just try it. The problem is that this might actually not work. Let's have a look. LS. And then let's look at some patch. Just one big pile of patch. Oh, it's actually a div, a simple div. Seems so. Hopefully there's an example. Yeah, so let's try this one. It doesn't seem to work. This seems to work. So this is what it's all about. All right. So let's cp change patch to yep, and then remove some stuff. RMRF SE ref policy. This is taking so long because of my audit rules. Let's change patch. And it should work. Actually. Yeah, this should work in theory. So let's just go back to the how to. So here it has apply source patch to Fedora package. So we did this stuff here. So this we did. So yeah, let's just do this here. And it's what's as it in explosive spec, I guess. Isn't it? Where is it? As it is policy spec. Okay, bump spec. Then whatever. Nano. Oh yeah, and now I got to add some stuff in there. So near the top, add patch 999 and let's change patch. So here we have patch 1. I'll just keep it that way, change. And then in the prep section, add this one. Prep. I guess that should do it. Now, you should install, build and install this. What do I need to? Build dependencies, yeah, but that's fine. That should be fine. Let's just run fed packages local. It's going to take a while. Oh, actually, it's not working at all. Why is that? I don't see why that. That sucks. I don't understand. This is new. Not helpful. Trip is also not helpful. See it. Let's see if there's some hints. Not really, but let's just try. Don't think that makes any sense. I don't fucking understand this. Reversed or previously applied patch detected. Christ sakes. That's slow as hell. These sites are slow as hell. No, give me a break. I don't understand this. Why isn't that explained to me? Explained somewhere, but just can't find it. No, I don't understand that. Oh, not at all. Why? Oh, why? Oh, why? No clue. But let's just try it anyways. Just gonna try a couple of things. It's not gonna help anything, anywhere. You don't have to wait for that, it's not gonna happen. Hell no, this is not gonna fucking happen. And I don't know why. explanation doesn't make sense to me. Very, very fucked up. Let's just fuck with this a little more. Oh. That shouldn't matter. I don't fucking have a clue. Okay, let's RM, RF, SE, Rev, Policy. So I'm thinking it's got to be something with the branch. Why in the fuck does everything have to be so fucking inconsistent? Probably just my own fault though. This is not going to happen. This is not. Going to fucking happen. And that sucks. Because now I'm also gonna have to fucking clone. And then we're going to have issues as well. Just gonna try it anyways. disappointing. Exactly the same shit. Exactly the same issue. Exactly the same issue is going to happen now. Actually, no. So it seems to actually work now. God damn it. So just because I, oh, actually no. So yeah, that's something I need to do as well. Turns out, after all. All right. These are your standard thingies. Those aren't in your build required, which that just fucking blows. And I did actually install Fedora Packager. So Fedora Packager should just, as far as I'm concerned, depend on GCC. But I guess I'm the only one that thinks that way. It'll take a while. Guess in the meantime I could install a new guest. I got some new email. So yeah, my internet service provider. Damn, he's crappy. They can't even set up a normal, simple web hosting shit stuffy. Why is this hanging? Well, it isn't hanging. So, CD. Yeah, I'll go to git gen ks and then gen ks and oh yeah, that's not going to happen. All right, so this takes some parameters. I'll just use the same ones as always. Test. The system name is test. Root password is abc123. This is just to test the package that I'm building. And the user is Joe. And the password for Joe is also abc123. Alright, and now I need to as root run this stuffy. Once this is done, if it's actually look at all these manual pages that it's creating. It's Welsh. And the problem is, this is so fucking slow because, well, I have these audit rules that basically need to write a event for each and every permission change of any every file. So here it's actually creating files constantly. So for every file it creates, it needs to write a record. And that's why this is so slow. But this system is just hanging straight on the internet, so it's auditing is important. I shouldn't do this build stuff on a on this system in the first place, I guess. I should have done this in a This is a good idea. Oh, actually, it will fill anyway because you need to specify this path dev sdj1. So, in the meanwhile, I'm just setting up this machine here. Hopefully. And then oh, it's done. So now there should be some packages here. Huh? Oh, it's probably in this no arc. Yeah. Why is this taking so long? is probably not enough. But that's not the point. The point is, if I can determine that that rule is actually properly added, then I'm okay already. It's more about the workflow of testing stuff, quickly modifying a package and see what effect change has. Basically, what the issue with my ISP, basically, so I got this web space XIZ tweak and now. So here, and then here I have this stuff directory. And then here I have basically a PNG and I'm getting permission denied. Because I want to basically have a index here for my pictures and stuff like that. But yeah, so that's not going to happen because it's, well, I don't have permission to access that file. So yeah, they can't actually even provide that stuff. So I told them, okay, never mind, don't worry about it, don't lose any sleep on it, I'll just go to a real web hoster instead. I don't know what the fuck they're doing with that space. If that doesn't work, that's the most simplest stuff. But if they can't even support that, then yeah. And I learned not to not to anger over that ISP. They're just incapable. And sometimes that incompetence is in my favor, and sometimes it is in their favor. I have this 100 megabit connection where I actually only pay for 35 megabits, but well, their incompetence causes them to not be able to, or actually maybe they are able to do it, but anyways, it causing them to cap me wrong. So I'm getting 65 megabits free from them because they are not capable to cap me properly. But on the other hand, my web space isn't worth anything because it can't actually use it to do anything. So 248. Can't I? Oh, it's not. It's 100.
So yeah, it's give and take. Okay, let's see if that rule actually was added. Source unconfined. That's not very intuitive. Damn, that's a lot. Oops. Seems fine. Something is still rather weird. But anyway, sudo yum group list. On desktop, nano etc security nano etc security access conf and just add screen zero for DDM actually. This should be fine. Group install. Gnome. This. Holy shit. The hell? That's not right. Oh, it is actually.
It's a lot of stuff.
And I just need to see, it's 10 megabits there. 10 megabytes, so that's 100 megabit. I just need to make sure that things work and that Pulse Audio is actually running without a roll transition, but I'm pretty sure of that already. But yeah, stuff will break. And anyways, the exercise is to just find a reasonable, easy way to test modifications. And I just want to know for myself how that stuff works. But it's actually pretty cool. Updated kernel. So yeah, this basically is going to be the way to do it. Just use FAT package to clone the package, I guess, or the repository, then change to the directory of your Fedora version, then run prep, then cd into the respective directory, either config or base, and just initialize a git repository in there and add the files that are in there, commit, and then basically modify your stuff, commit that as well, and then just create a git diff of the last commit on head, I guess. Put that in the one level above, the directory one level above, then edit your spec file, add the patch in there, in the require section, I guess it's called, and then the prep section, add it in there, so that with the P1, then update your version, bump spec, and then it's fat package local, to build that package locally, I guess. And then send that, once that's built, I guess send it or install it, I guess.
And if, yeah, you might want to blacklist the package that you modify, because else when you update and the packets get updated by upstream, then your changes are gone again. So you might want to blacklist that, and whenever it is updated, send yourself a notification that the package has an update, and so that you can actually manually do that step again. And actually, the consecutive runs, you can actually script that fully, I guess, because you already have the patches, and you just need to actually copy the patch over and include it. You don't have to change anything at that point, I guess. This is a bit quicker, although this guest also has a bunch of audit rules, but it doesn't have rules for when it actually changed, for when files are changed. So that's just saves a lot. The audit rules that I have on my hypervisor, yeah, a lot of stuff is logged there. All these attribute changes on files, or if someone writes to a file, it gets logged. That's why I have so many friggin' audit logs. So I have 1600 megabytes, I guess, about. Because these are 100 each. So. That's about what I said. But I'm logging up to 80 of these fuckers. So all in all, it's about 10 G's of logs. So that's a lot of logging. I'll just remove it, because if it's not working now, then fuck that. But I suppose it's gonna take a while. Disk. It's getting hammered. Cleaning up. My CPU is 60 degrees. That's pretty hot. Why is this cleanup so taking so long? Whoops. What the hell? That doesn't look too good. Let's see if I can still log on to that system. Oh, it's done. Shut down. Reboot now. That's gonna be fun. Why is that? Let's have a look at this stuff. Wow, it's slow as hell. That's a USB disk. It's it is just slow. Terminal. This is first boot. Sudo shell. Whoops. Damn. Stop bothering me. I'll search MABCTS today. It's clean. Now let's have a look at the Pulse Audio process. If it runs with System R, then we're fucked up, and if not, then oh. It's fine. So it runs with Unconfined R, and it runs fine. So that's great. So yeah, this mission is completed, I guess. But there's, of course, so there are some some thingies. But this is at least a fine start so that we can get rid of system R, running with the system R role, because that's bad. But for confined users, there might be issues, I guess. Oops, wrong. All right. Nano SSH known. Remove this one here. We don't need that. And yeah, also remove. I'll just leave it in here. The test network one for shits and giggles. So yeah, this actually works. So that patch. So that's how you quickly test that stuff, I guess.